Hello aspirants, in this video we are going to discuss an issue. A question has been framed on it and based on it will be discussed. The issue here is about lack of global consensus on terrorism. The major aspects involved here are, one is Maulana Masood Azhar, who is the JM chief whom India wants to ban at UN, and this UN sanctions committee is looking into this, but China has vetoed this India's proposal quite often. So what is the reason for that? Then second aspect is about even the India's proposed comprehensive convention on international terrorism, which is India's proposal at United Nations to be adopted. That draft has not gone ahead. It is since 1996 that it has been discussed, but nothing has come out of it. So why is that so? Because of lack of global consensus on terrorism. And the third aspect is of course about Taliban too, the good Taliban and bad Taliban, how sides indulge in talks with Taliban. Even US and Russia are finding sides among these sections of terrorist organizations. So all this needs to be discussed and understood. That is what we'll go ahead here. So the question which has been framed is, China's decision to veto India's proposal to ban JEM chief Masood Azhar at the UN is part of the larger picture depicting lack of global consensus on terrorism. Elucidate. So of course there are issues between India and China has been supporting Pakistan. So of course Maulana Masood Azhar, who is based in Pakistan in Karachi, so there are clear evidences of this, but then China refuses to have him designated as a terrorist and banned under UN sanctions committee. So the reason being that it supports Pakistan because it also has established its Gwadar port there, China-Pakistan economic corridor, which is going to pass through Pakistan. Plus even for its One Belt, One Road initiative, it needs support from various quarters, and that is the reason why India and China are facing difficulties. Even at nuclear suppliers group, we saw that India's membership is majorly opposed by China. And the reason being, China again says that if energy membership is given to India, then it should be given to Pakistan as well. So that is the condition put forth, that both of them should get the membership. There should be clear criteria how membership is given, and then both should be becoming members. So such stance taken by China at international forums, clearly supporting Pakistan and for that matter opposing India, are visible. So now in this case, the Maulana Masood Azhar's case is different. That is what is argued. So the difference here is, one, Maulana Masood Azhar was the one who was exchanged for hostages in the Kandahar scenario. If you remember the Kandahar, in Kandahar, which is in Afghanistan, IC-814 airplane was hijacked and it was bound to Kandahar. It stopped there and the hostages, majorly Indians, they would be released. If the condition put by the hijackers was, they would be released only if terrorists were handed over, who were under the arrest of Indian authorities, would be handed over, and one of them was Maulana Masood Azhar. So there is clear linkage that Maulana Masood Azhar was a terrorist who was exchanged in this scenario. Then even in his book, a book which he has written, From Imprisonment to Freedom, Maulana Masood Azhar clearly details the entire terror plot to hijack the plane and his links with Taliban. So this all is clearly in front of the people. He is the one who claims that he has met Osama bin Laden in Afghanistan. He has traveled to Somalia and helped recruitment for Al-Qaeda. So all such claims are being made by him openly. So then there are no doubts that he is not a terrorist. Then what is it that stops China from declaring him, banning him under UN sanctions committee? So that is the question. Even after 2 years, after the 9/11 attack, after that Jaish-e-Mohammed, the organization which he heads, was declared as a terror group by United Nations. So this is the delay which we see in dealing with terrorism, tackling with terrorism at the global fora. So even the parliament attacks which took place in 2000, the Pathankot attacks as recent as in 2016, the Uri attacks, here again the clear linkage of clear idea that it was associated with Jaish-e-Mohammed and the mastermind was Maulana Masood Azhar is clear. Still, there is no lack of evidence till the banning of this organization and its chief is stalled. Summing up about Maulana Masood Azhar too, you can look down here. So he has declared as the mastermind of Pathankot terror attacks. He was released from Indian prison in 1999 during IC-814 Kandahar hijack. Then he is responsible for the terror attack on Indian Parliament in 2001. He has undertaken several attacks, masterminded several attacks in Jammu and Kashmir. So he is the chief of Jaish-e-Mohammed. He resides in Pakistan. So though there are even the description at United Nations of Maulana Masood Azhar, you can see. So the terror attacks here again, it is Parliament attacks, Jammu and Kashmir Legislative Assembly attack, and Pathankot Airways attacks. There are clear linkages of Jaish-e-Mohammed. So then what stops international organizations from declaring him as a terrorist? So though this resolution has been proposed by UN, UK, US, UK and France, but it is opposed by China. Plus also Russia has done nothing. It has been a mute spectator of this. Neither it has supported it, neither opposed it. So abstention is what Russia is looking at. So now here again the question arises that why there is lack of global consensus on terrorism. So we'll look into that aspect. So there are talks with Taliban which has been undertaken. So after 9/11 attacks, the US Twin Tower attacks, after that we saw that fight with Taliban and Al-Qaeda and all these terrorist groups was undertaken, and UN Security Council resolution was also passed in 2001 against all these terrorist organizations. But later it was seen that since 2010 at least, the narrative has changed now. There is lack of global consensus, because in 2011, the UN Sanctions Committee also separated, this UN Security Council resolution separated Al-Qaeda from Taliban. So there's a separate Taliban committee and separate Al-Qaeda committee. The reason being that there were talks being undertaken with Taliban to bring them on the negotiating table and getting their support. So this complicates the whole matter. So when you talk with terrorists, then they come on the table talking at the same platform, talking with the countries, then how will the fight against terrorism take place? So there are concerns here. So this talks with Taliban has resulted in giving even Pakistan the edge, that now it also claims that terrorists can be negotiated with and rather than be fought against. So that is one, talks with Taliban, which is complicating the matter. Second is US-Russia. So with respect to US and Russia, they were initially in 2001, after the 9/11 attacks, it was seen that the two countries came together. Russia completely supported USA and it allowed US to set up bases in Central Asia and take over, you know, fight in Afghanistan against the Taliban. But then later it was seen that Russia, now it questions that how is US present in Central Asia, and this it being present in its backyard is similar to Russia being present in Mexico, for example. So now it is completely against any US presence in Afghanistan and these countries. So their relations have got complicated. So the two political powers, the two national powers actually, are on divergence on the concept of terrorism. Then again, China and Pakistan have come together, plus Russia is also again supporting China and Pakistan. The three together have brought in another global consensus amongst themselves on terrorism. Because now Russia wants to establish itself in Afghanistan, and in Afghanistan, Taliban is one major power. So there are talks with Taliban which are undergoing, and USA supports one group of terrorists or these Talibans in Afghanistan, plus Russia supports another set, and again the fight amongst the nations is the fight, they're selecting their groups, which groups are supporting them. So this again is of course not in tune with the requirement of global consensus on terrorism. So this aspect is seen. So at United Nations, Russia is calling for a flexible approach to remove some Taliban figures from the UN sanctions list as a part of efforts to foster peaceful dialogue between Afghanistan and Taliban movement. So this is the demand made by Russia. On the same lines, US is also pushing for removal of other groups in Afghanistan from sanctions. So there again, they are deciding who are their supporters and working in favor for them. So this is what China is again doing with respect to India and Pakistan. So here again, shows lack of global consensus on terrorism. Even Russia, we saw, supported Pakistan. So at the BRICS summit, this is Brazil, Russia, India, and China, and South Africa. This BRICS summit, which was conducted a few months back in October 2016, the Heart of Asia conference on Afghanistan in December 2016. So at these summits too, Russia and China came together and kept India's desire for tough statements on cross-border terrorism emanating from Pakistan to not be coming on this forum. They said that Russian ambassador said this, that these should be discussed at global forums, not on these summits. So again, at global forums too, we say they oppose such initiatives. So then India does not have a platform to put forth its views there. So as we saw, India's proposed comprehensive convention on international terrorism. So this is a draft proposal by India in 1996 and was to be introduced. It has been introduced but not yet adopted by UN General Assembly. The reason being that it calls for a universal definition of terrorism. There's no good terrorist, bad terrorist. But then the countries involved, various countries, US, Latin American countries, even OIC, Organization of Islamic Countries, have their own viewpoints and they are not ready to bring in a global consensus on terrorism. So that is on this point that this comprehensive convention on international terrorism is also stalled. So India calls for ban of all groups, regardless of the country in which they are operating. There should be complete cutoff of act for funds and safe havens for these terrorists. So that is what it is calling for, the comprehensive convention. So domestic laws should be amended accordingly that no cross-border terrorism and such offenses can be tolerated. So US and its allies, they have concerns over the definition of terrorism. So because US soldiers also undertake certain acts which are against international international interventions without UN mandate, then in such cases they may be also falling under the definition of terrorists. So there are concerns of such sorts too. Latin American countries also, they have concerns that international humanitarian laws and human rights are ignored in this comprehensive convention. Then Organization of Islamic Countries, of course, will have concerns. They feel that this will be used to target Pakistan and restrict right to self-determination of Palestinians and Kashmiris. So they have their own concerns. So this is what we see is the status of terrorism and how fighting amongst themselves, countries fighting amongst themselves, is helping in terrorists gathering strength and becoming powerful. So that is it. Thank you.